Hello, everyone. This week in Jewish history, a very important event in Middle Eastern politics. In November of 1977, Egyptian President Anwar Sadat flew to Israel to meet with his erstwhile enemy, Menachem Begin, and speak to the Israeli Knesset about the possibility of peace. This initial visit ultimately led to an Israeli-Egyptian accord and the current status quo of a fragile but nevertheless enduring peace is the result of that courageous trip. Anwar Sadat was a very important Egyptian leader whose connection to Jewish history is especially important because in November of 1977 he made a very heroic attempt to make peace with his northern neighbor, the State of Israel, and in fact that peace has more or less held despite some tensions since the 1980s. Here he is shaking hands with Menachem Begin, with President Jimmy Carter looking in the background. This is at Camp David, the U.S. presidential retreat, where many of the details were worked out between these two leaders. His history with Israel is wrapped up with the military conflicts between the countries. In particular, the 1967 war, also known as the Six-Day War, was one that devastated Egypt. The president, Gamal Abdel Nasser, had mounted his troops and his prepared his tanks to invade Israel through the Sinai Peninsula, along with invasions from Jordan and Syria at the same time. But the Israelis, remarkably, in a lightning victory, were not only able to retain their territory, which is shown here in yellow, they actually expanded it, taking over the Golan Heights in the north, the West Bank, which is Shomron and Yehuda, and the Gaza Strip to the south, and the massive Sinai Peninsula, which was taken, of course, from Egypt. This was a huge blow to Egyptian pride and Arab pride in general, something that Sadat was able to regain by his surprise attack in Israel in 1973, known to Arabs as the War of Ramadan, to Jews as the Yom Kippur War, and to the rest of the world as the October War. Although Sadat was not successful in making more than very marginal gains, really just out on the very western portion of the Sinai Peninsula, nevertheless, he did inflict very heavy casualties on the Israeli army and the Jewish population in general. And as a result, many Arabs felt that Israel was not completely invincible, and in fact, Arab armies could make an impact on the country. Sadat's take on all of this, however, was not to prepare for yet another war, but to use that momentum to create a peace, which is something he did in 1977 when he traveled to Israel in an unprecedented state journey, specifically to meet with his enemy Menachem Begin and to speak to the Knesset. Here's a photograph, a rather remarkable photograph of the period, that shows Sadat shaking hands with Menachem Begin, who was one of Israel's more hawkish political leaders, along with Yitzhak Shamir applauding on the right, also a much more hawkish individual in the Israeli Knesset. Together with President Jimmy Carter, they were able to work out a deal which essentially dictated the return of the Sinai Peninsula territory to Egypt, a massive territorial concession which certainly assuaged the Egyptians. However, they were not willing to take the tiny bit of territory to the north, the Gaza Strip. It remained in Israel, and Israel inherited the very considerable economic and demographic challenges of that part of the world. Israelis took the news of the return of the Sinai Peninsula to Egypt with mixed reviews. On the one hand, Israelis were generally very pleased at the concept that there would be a lasting peace with their neighbor to the south, but many Jews had begun to settle, particularly along the Mediterranean coast in the Sinai Peninsula, and viewed the return of this land as a betrayal of basic Israeli principles, and so it was a very wrenching experience, which would be repeated a quarter century later with the evacuation of the Gaza Strip. What Sadat earned for this was not the undying loyalty of all Egyptians, but rather the burning animosity of the Muslim Brotherhood in particular. Muslim Brotherhood members infiltrated his bodyguard to very high levels, and in fact, in October of 1981, while he and his retinue were watching a military parade, they turned around and opened fire on Sadat, hitting him with 37 bullets, and he died in the stands there of blood loss while the parade went on. So he was unfortunately assassinated for the audacity of making peace with Israel. The legacy of his rule, however, says much about the state of Egypt and the state of Israel, and his leadership really created a much more lasting peace in the Middle East. Well, that's it for this week. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I look forward to speaking with you in the future.